All right, so here's fetal circulation. Here's the placenta, here's the amnion. What's gonna happen is the mom basically does what the lungs should do. So the mom is going to send oxygenated blood via the umbilical vein, yes, the vein, through the ductus venosus, through the liver, and then it's gonna end up in the right atrium. Now the baby has what we call a patent foramen ovale, which is basically what you know as the hole in the heart, because since the right ventricle doesn't need to pump the blood into the lungs, then it allows the oxygenated blood to go straight to the left atrium, where the left atrium will go into the rest of the body, and it uses what we call the ductus arteriosum. Okay, so really, just to reiterate, the placenta is delivering oxygen-rich blood via the umbilical vein, and the reason that it bypasses the ventricles is essentially because the mom is doing what the lungs should do. This is called the ductus venosus right here. Here's the liver, here's the diaphragm, and then the patent foramen ovale. If you see a little, I can put a little Q-tip right through there, and that's the foramen ovale where the right atrium and the left atrium join. When the baby is born and takes its first breath, the lungs will inflate, and that will cause the pressure will cause the foramen ovale to shut, and the ductus arteriosum becomes the ligamentum arteriosum. Okay, so again, placenta, amnion, umbilical vein, ductus venosus, liver, foramen ovale, right atrium, left atrium, and then you have a ductus arteriosum right in here.